What's up, everyone? Welcome to the grand finale of the $1,000 holdout challenge. I did an episode with every single race, and now we have six contestants left. The top three is going to leave with a good amount of prize money. And now today, as the ultimate finale, I'm going to be playing random. Let's do it. All right, the first opponent is going to be Spotted, the Platinum Protoss player. Now, Spotted was the winner of the Zerg episode, and I think he had the best time overall. And we're going to get Zerg again. Now, he's probably going to be happy to see that because he might be a little more confident already playing against Zerg. Oh, let me turn on my health bars here. But I have obviously learned from my mistakes. And I think what I want to do is go for Ravagers pretty fast as well. Now, how do I want to do that exactly? I'm not quite sure. I think I want to go for a proxy hatch. Let's see. So the last game, I'm trying to remember how... This is actually pretty funny. We got the same mashup. The last time we played, I don't remember what map it was. Or, well, I kind of remember what the map looks like, but I don't remember which one it was. But I think I tried to proxy hatch or do like some kind of early pull, and he just managed to defend it pretty easily by walling off. And he had a really good SimCity with adepts that I had to like go here with my units, and the adepts were shooting me on the ramp. Like, it was all very well done. That's what I remember. Now, I would go for a hatchery first, but I think here, the pull first should be okay. Now, the reason why I didn't do this super committed... Oh, he's actually going to go for the probes guy, so he's going to see him Zerg. He's, like I said, he's probably going to be happy to see that. He's not going to come back, okay. What was I going to say? Oh, yeah, I think I want to make some spine crawlers as well. Oh, so he walled on the low ground. Okay, well, this could be very cool. Let's see, what am I going to do with these? I wonder why he walled on the low ground exactly, by the way. Like, could it be that he's afraid of... mass Zergling? Or I'm trying to think about all the races, right? Because it's not just Zerg that I could have been. So I wonder what he was afraid of exactly. Now I'm gonna go for the hatchery in the main here. I think that is the best idea. He does have two gateways. Like, this is gonna be a little challenging to break, I have to admit. I'm gonna go for the Roach Worm. Looks like this build was almost perfect. If I skipped one drone, it would have been perfect. But having this amount of gas is still pretty good for me. Let's see. I think it's 300 gas. Yeah, exactly. A Ravager is 100 gas, so I need 300 gas. Now, just to remind you guys of the rules of this, it's actually pretty simple. The person with who survives the longest wins, right? In this case, the top three wins the prize money. So he just needs to survive for as long as possible. He's allowed to hide buildings and whatever he wants to do. The only rule is that if I play against a Terran, they're not allowed to fly their buildings to the corner because that would be a little bit too big of an advantage. So that's... as far as I can tell, literally the only rule, as far as I remember, I should say. Now he's going to go for the forge and he's going to make cannons, exactly. So here's where the Ravagers are going to be really good. I'm really tempted to finish this because I am... ooh, this is going to be a tough decision for me, guys. I'm going to be able to make at least one roach from this, but I didn't get Burrow. I think I should probably go for the cancel and make it again. Oh, this is actually a tough one, guys. Yeah, I think I'm going to go for the cancel here. He already had the pylon there as well for cannons. I mean, that wouldn't necessarily have mattered that much. But I do think since he had two gateways already... oh, that's not exactly hidden over the Overlord pillar. Yeah, okay. He's going to go for mass cannons on the high ground here too. There's one cannon over there, which is kind of funny. But did he stop chasing me already? I'm not quite sure, actually. I don't see the Zealot anymore, which is interesting. I'm going to try to build a hatchery in the corner here. Let me just get hit by the probe so it actually fits. There we go. And I'm probably going to be able to pull him back. Now, he is making a lot of cannons next to each other. I'm not quite sure he's expecting the Ravagers here, guys. The Ravagers are going to be freaking killer. I do have to say, if he went for a Stargate here, I don't think he has a Cybernetics Core, but if he would have gone for a Stargate, that would have been really, really good, because that would save him so much time. I would actually have to go up to a freaking, to a freaking lair to be able to make Hydras and stuff, right? Now, I didn't do the best job of rallying my stuff across. Let me buy all this one more time. Those should both die. Zealot's gonna die pretty fast as well. And now I'm gonna be able to depower that pylon already. And he's not gonna be happy with this, guys. This is not the start he was hoping for, I'm sure. Now I'm gonna be able to make another hatchery over here. Let's see. Is that a cannon? There's no cannon yet. I guess I'll kill the forge. Doesn't really matter what I kill, probably, but I guess I'll kill the forge. I'm gonna make more hatcheries over here. Here we go, drop a couple of Biles, get this one to be a Ravager and this one as well. Now, I don't exactly remember what his last time was, but I think it was about 8:45. And I mean, so far, it looks like we're going to be able to break that. I mean, I know he's not dead yet, but he's taking a lot of damage already. In the last time, I don't quite remember if he had probes out on the map to make proxy buildings with. I feel like he was really just focused on defending the main base, but I could be wrong there. I'm going to start biling the probe, so it's going to be harder for him harder for him to run away with them, obviously. Okay, I'm gonna buy all this Nexus down. I think, judging by his movement, yeah, I'm gonna make a couple Zerglings to scout the map. I feel like that would be a good idea. I just need to make sure to use my Biles every time I have them on cooldown, which... if I have my Ravagers split, that's going to be a little harder. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring my Ravagers together. You guys can scout around the map. Let's see if he has mined away the gold base. He says, oof, which makes me believe that he doesn't have anything on the map. The one thing I was worried about, Ravagers, yeah, of course I'm going to make them. But I do know that they can get a little tricky, guys, and it might still have stuff hidden out on the map. So I'm not going to, you know, assume that the game is over just yet. I have definitely had something weird going on with my rally. Like, I'm not quite sure. I feel like I fixed my rally a couple times, but then I didn't. Let's see if I can find any buildings around the map. Zerglings are obviously going to be a little better at that than the roaches are. Just going to split them in a couple groups. There we go. Oh, I can actually buy all these at the same time, I believe. Yeah, look at that damage. Terrible damage from the Ravagers, guys. Now I got a couple more Zerglings here as well. Kill me slowly. No, no, no. I refuse to be distracted by this spot, and I'm sorry. You embarrassed me with the 845 time in the last episode, so now I'm going to have to make it a little better. Oh, this is... Wait, no, he did mine it out, right? Wait, how did you get there? Wait, how did the Zergling get there? Okay, it's over there. I see. So, wait, I need another drone to mine that out for my roaches? I actually had no idea. Wait, that is crazy. Wait, I can kill the rocks with these Biles, actually. Any Biles could kill the rocks pretty fast. Dude, I was wondering, how the hell did my Zergling get through, but my roaches couldn't? But I guess you actually don't fit in one square with the roach. That is... Yeah, kind of surprising. Didn't expect it. I'm still going to scout the rest of the map in case he has something hidden. I would like to have this one roach to kill that probe if I could. That would be ideal. I'm going to send one thingy down here. Let's see. He's probably going to make a gas if I had to guess. I already sent a couple Ravagers over there, I suppose. Let's see. Is he going to be able to build something? Is he out of money? I can't quite tell. So that probe is going to fall. Is it the last building? And there we go. All right. I think... I always say the margin of time is about 2 seconds from the game actually ending to the rewind. I think this was probably 6:39, which means that I killed him about 2 minutes faster. Now, I can already guarantee you guys this is going to be a very competitive episode, because even though his time was 8:45-ish before, nothing went as flat. Oh, that's sad. I mean, it's still a pretty good time. I was going to say, this time could still be very, very high. I feel like most of the times throughout, you know, for all of these contestants was about 7 minutes to like 6:30. So this could still be a top 3 time. It's obviously not what he was hoping for, but that was the first game. Let's go to game number 2.
And the second opponent is going to be Freyko, the Gold League Protoss, who got second in the Protoss episode. Now, I do have to admit, I don't really remember that game. I do feel like he was very early in the episode. Oh, we got Terran, all right. I do think it was very early in that episode, like the first or second game. I think I remember that one of those got into, you know, the grand finale from there. Now, what am I going to do? I think I definitely want to go for a little bit of a proxy rax here. Actually, I found something out in like my 1v1 ladder in my random to rank 1 series. I was playing a little bit off stream. And I figured out that one build is really good in TVP. And that is just doing a proxy Reaper. Because people are typically not going to... I mean, this is different because it's a holdout challenge, right? But people are typically not going to scout for proxies. Because you could be Zerg, for example, right? So you can even build it like here. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm not sure what my follow-up is yet. Normally, a proxy Reaper is not a 100% all-in. Here, it obviously is going to be. Because I want to kill him as fast as possible. Now, the time he wants to beat... I'm always worried that I forget it right away, but I'm pretty sure the time was 6:39, right? 6:39. Oh, he did scout for a proxy. Look at that. Wait. No. Guys, he wasn't looking for a proxy. He was going to hide the probe. Okay, that is funny that he scouts him because of that. I mean, I did say this is a holdout challenge, so it's going to be a little different. But all right, he hasn't reacted to it yet, so that is nice. And now we know that he has a probe out on the map. See, what is my strategy going to be here? So Reaper should be able to take care of the main base, or well, not of the entire base, but of the probes. The Reaper should be able to shut down the economy pretty fast. And then if I get like Cyclones out, I can hunt the map pretty well, I think. Yeah, Cyclones might be the best. Marines also have a really good amount of DPS. Let's see what I can find here. So he's going to go for cannons right away. That makes sense. I wouldn't be surprised if he's also building a cannon up here. That would be a very cool move. You know what? I think I'm just going to build a factory like right in front of his base. I'm going to patrol... Okay, this is a good move, I think, by me. I'm going to patrol the SCV here so I can see if the cannon is going to finish, right? Because the cannon would shoot the SCV before I would lose the Reaper to it. That's basically the idea. Now, I could still be unlucky that the cannon finishes at the perfect time and just kills the Reaper, but I guess we'll see. I think one or two Reapers should be enough to just be able to make...
you know, his probe line disappeared pretty much. Let's see. Yeah, he doesn't have a pylon here. Oh, he does actually have a pylon, but he doesn't have a cannon yet. But this Reaper, this is pretty much the purpose of this Reaper. I'm just going to be killing all of these probes. Even this cannon is not going to be able to protect the right side of that mineral line. Now, what am I going to make besides this? Oh, this one can probably go away. I have one more Reaper. That Reaper I'm going to use to scout the map because there are enough cannons up already, of course. I think I'm going to go for a second factory. I know it sounds pretty crazy, but the second factory is a pretty good shot here. I'm going to use the barracks for vision. And then with my probe and my Reaper, I'm going to be scouting the entire map. Now, I did say before, the static defenses are... They are probably the best thing. A lot of players didn't go for the static defenses, but realistically, those are the best thing you can make. Because I need so much time to kill these. You know, even if I get siege tanks, I'm going to need so much time to kill these. Let's see, I'll probably be able to snipe that probe through the cannon. Yeah, he's making so many freaking cannons, and I know he's still... Oh, I found it! Oh, no. No, wait, I did misclick the Reaper. That's not what I want to do. I have two because I was so excited. I was like, I'll army Hotkey. Okay, so we kill that probe. Now, he could still have another probe on the map. Yeah, actually, I think it would surprise me if he didn't, because if he has like the plan to send one probe out on the map, it would make sense if he sends another one out too. I have tanks here anyway already, so I don't necessarily need the second Reaper to protect his main, I guess. Protect his main from me. I don't know how to say it. Protect his main from multiple probes sneaking out. Like, this thing is going to be able to shut things down. Really happy with the second factory. Yeah, exactly. That's what I thought. We are going to find that probe. Okay, that is awesome. Now, I'm going to send these SCVs to kill this. You know what? I don't think it's even a crazy idea to send my workers to kill that. Let's see. Can I kill more probes? I don't think I can. Let's see. Can I get the perfect spot? Doesn't look like it now, unfortunately. Now, unsieged tanks have more DPS, I believe, than siege tanks against a single target, so I'm gonna be able to keep these ones unseized for now. It's already 4 minutes in game. I do feel really scared because it's gonna take so long to kill all of these cannons, but at the same time, I can kill a bunch of these pylons already, right? Maybe I should be going for this cannon over here on the right side. I bet he's gonna be a little surprised to see the SCV show up here, but like, it's just, why not, right? It's gonna help me kill stuff faster, so why would I not do that? Probably should stop making depots and just use like the what's it called, the supply drop. I think that makes sense as well. Okay, so these ones I'm gonna unseize now because I have pretty much free access already. Let me I dropped the mule. Okay, that was completely automatic. I don't actually mind the mule either, but I guess the supply drop could have been a little better. I should probably be using these units to scout the map a little more. Oh, he escaped with a probe, actually. Okay, I need to send the Reapers on the case over there. The Reapers have to kill those. That's a little bit of a mistake by me that I let that one slip through. I mean, I have a freaking squad looking for him all over the place. I think I'm going to use... Oh, no! I'm going to lose that Reaper to the cannon. Oh, that is a... When did I even send that? I thought At some point, I had the Reaper over here that was attacking the Nexus, and I thought I gave up on it. Now, let's see. Where's the probe going, guys? We have to find that probe. We can't let it live for too long. Gonna send a couple more SCVs to the bottom side as well to make sure that he's not escaping me for too long. Because I'll kill the cannon first. I might as well. Like, these things are not gonna die anymore anyway. This looks so funny. My freaking SCV tray looking for buildings. But I don't know where the probe is. I think he's done a really good job of dodging me, guys. We are not gonna find that probe right away. And there we go. The gas is over there. So he snuck onto the left side. Oh, we're gonna kill that probe. Oh, wait. That's a good sign. No, that means... Wait, I think that was the last probe, right? Else... Yeah, I think I only saw one escape there, so I think that's the last probe. We're going to be rushing through that building. I have a lot of tanks stuck here. Okay, that is funny. Next time I know, I need to place my buildings a little bit better. But it looks... Dude, it would be very sad for the other contestants if this was what going to break the time because I had my tank stuck. But I think I'm going to be able to kill this. If he has one more probe hidden, he will be able to beat the previous time. Else, this is going to be about 6:30, looks like. And there we go. I think it was 6:13 and 6:14, so he's not going to beat the previous time. But like I said, 6 minute plus is always going to be competitive. Really good idea with the cannons. I think one thing that really could have made... I feel like this could have made a big difference. If this, instead of a cyber core, was just a couple cannons. Like, I know he wanted batteries. If you guys are wondering why he built a cybernetic core, it's because he wanted to make shield batteries. That's a great idea. But if this were like a couple cannons instead, I feel like that could have been massive. Because the SCVs and Reapers would not be able to kill this. It would buy him a lot of time. Maybe he can get another gas up here, gas over here. But for now, he's going to be last place, but still a pretty competitive time. I think it's 6:13. Let's go for game number three. The third round is going to be against a Platinum Terran. He was second place in the Terran holdout. I think he was the first player to actually make the planetary against me. Like, I think the game I played against him was a TVT, obviously. Oh, I got Zerg. It was a TVT. And actually, I'm going to cancel it. I'm going to go for a 12 pool here. And he went for Marauder Turret Planetary, I believe. And I ended up going for a Thor. I'm not 100% sure he went for the Planetary, but I am pretty sure it was the Thor build that I did. The proxy Thor that was very, very, very strong. Now, this time I got Zerg. I do think, even though Zerg gave my opponents the best times so far, right? In all the three episodes that I did before. The highest times were from the Zerg episode. I do think getting random from Zerg for me is pretty sick. Because going for fast Ravagers and them not necessarily knowing what I'm going to do right away, I think is really, really strong. Now, I would imagine that he's going to scout me pretty early as well. But yeah, the last person didn't actually scout me. He just hit a probe and found my barracks. I do think, by the way, I didn't really mention it before. It would have 100% been a good move for the probe to attack my barracks in that last game, making the proxy. Like, if someone's wondering why he didn't do that, he was either not paying attention or thinking, I'm just going to make cannons. I'm going to survive anyway. I'm just going to go with my probe to the corner and that's it. Which is, you know, I can see that. Like, that definitely makes sense. Actually, I think I'm going to mine with 5 in gas instead of... Yeah, I think that makes sense. Oh, I didn't return that one. I was wondering why I was being so weird. Wait, what the hell is that thing doing? You guys saw that? That was not... Okay, well, that looked a little weird, to be honest. Okay, so I'm going to be able to make 3 roaches right away. I think... Wait, is it 13? I'm not sure if it's 13 or 14 drones that you normally have. But I think for now, the economic situation looks fine. So I'm not going to make more than that. Just gonna make sure I have my 3 larvae. I got my extra overlord. And I mean, I'm expecting him to do a little bit of the same. Like, I think a lot of these guys have been practicing. I've been seeing it in the text channels, the group chats that we have, right, for the holdout challenge. So I would imagine that my opponent here is gonna do something similar to what he did before, which is like the one base, maybe Marauders. Doesn't look like Marauders right away. Like Planetary, and probably just like a more... I guess like a more efficient version of that. Now, I could have made this Ravager instantly as well, but I decided to make the Roach first. It's not going to, you know, make a big difference here. But I do think it's important that I get as many Ravagers to the other side of the map as possible. So he's making Marines and a Bunker. Okay. I feel like it's a little bit different than the thing we saw last time. And this could be because I'm playing random, of course, right? That he didn't know that I'm, you know, what race I'm going to be. Oh, he's going to go for the Overlord. Oh, no, he's not. Yeah, I would say that would be very risky. I'm actually curious if that would pay off for him. So the SCV is, I think, going to the corner of the map. He looked a little indecisive there. Not quite 100% sure what he was going for, but I think going for, you know, maybe like a corner base or something. Now, here come the Ravagers. I do wonder what would happen if one of these guys would get an air unit up, right? Like, air units would be freaking terrifying, right? Okay, so I think I need... Actually, I talked to my friend about this the other day. You need 7 Ravagers to one-shot the bunker. Yo, he really needs to be repairing that, though. No, you have to repair the bunker. Not the wall. You have to repair the bunker, my friend. That's gonna be... Oh, that is a big mistake there. He didn't quite repair the bunker. Now, it could already be time for me to get, what's it called, to get Zerglings out. He's gonna lose the Marines as well. I think he's making a Cyclone, looks like. Maybe I should... I could be buying the factory as well. Okay, it looks like he's playing a little greedier, to be honest. There's no Planetary to be found. I'm not sure if he's running away or trying to surround me because it's a holdout challenge. It's kind of hard to tell, actually. But there we go. Oh, wait, that bio could be huge. Look at the bios. Oh, we are gonna kill a couple. Okay, now how do I split these? I think I'm gonna split these like this. I'm gonna get 1 Ravager over here and 1 Ravager to the other side. This is gonna be... Like, Cyclos are not gonna be that strong against Ravagers, to be honest. Like, they are just so freaking flimsy. And he's not paying attention to the Cyclone either. This is not looking super hot for our Terran friend over here, guys. Definitely a couple mistakes being made. I think the Ravager over there probably got a couple SCV kills as well. This one is gonna find another SCV. Let's see, is there one hiding in the corner? There is 1 SCV over there. He's flying the buildings away. I hope he remembers that he's not actually allowed to fly. Exactly, he lands them again. I was gonna say, I don't think he's gonna cheat. Like, he knows the rules. I actually clarified with him beforehand. Now, I still have to check for a potential other SCV hidden. Like, there could be 1 over here, for example. I think I'm gonna send 1 to the bottom side, 1 over here. Like, keep in mind that he also sent an SCV out pretty early, right? That's actually... Hey, that's a pretty cool idea to drop the mules there. Yeah, you wouldn't expect it to be useful, but either I waste my time shooting them or he gets money for another building. It's, I'm not sure if he has something out on the map. That is actually a fantastic idea. So the barracks is over there. Gonna be able to kill that relatively fast. This Ravager didn't find anything new. Gonna make sure to kill that. And now I'm actually considering... Wait, maybe... You know what? I'm gonna keep the watchtower. I think that's a good idea. I was going to say, I'm considering going back with all of these Ravagers so I can kill his buildings a little faster. So there's a gas here as well, and a gas here. Going to be able to get them 2-for-1, which is quite nice. So still happy that I actually decided to look around, because it didn't seem like my opponent had a lot, but he definitely still had a couple buildings over here. And now he's going to be revealed because the main command center has fallen. He could have another building somewhere else. Let me try to go around to find that. That gas is going to die. Let me drop a bile there as well. And it looks like that is going to be it. All right, dude. I'm a little sad for him because he was, in my opinion, one of the most impressive players from the regular episodes. But this game, I feel like everything went wrong. He didn't repair the bunker. He didn't micro... Well, the Cyclone wasn't really going to matter, to be fair. But he didn't micro the Cyclone. Didn't repair the bunker is the biggest deal. Could have made more bunkers as well. Maybe gone for a faster tank or stuff like that. But maybe he was just a little bit too greedy. And that could be the random effect, guys. I don't want to judge him too hard because I have never done a holdout challenge as the person trying to defend against a random player. Like, I don't even know what kind of strategy I would do, but this sadly is going to be the bottom time, which means that Spotted is almost confirmed in the top three already, because after three matches, he is the leading player. He needs all players to catch up for him to not be in the prize money, so that's great for him. But sadly, due to here, he's not completely eliminated, but I do think he's pretty much out of the question for the prize at this point. All players remaining would have to score below 524 for him to come into prize money, so that's a little sad, but you did your best. Still proud of you. For now, let's go to game number four.
The fourth opponent is Mozzarella, a Diamond Zerg player. I think he was first place in the Protoss holdout episode. And in my opinion, from having played against all these guys, I would say that this player is the big favorite for the first place, because he had a really impressive time with a bunch of Nidus's hiding drones and stuff, and that was really, really awesome. So I do think he has a decent shot at getting the first place prize. Now, so far, I feel like the players are a little nervous. Like, I think everyone has gotten a worse time than they did previously so far. I think Freyko was the one that was the closest to his original time, so Freyko definitely held it together. But so far, the players do seem a little nervous, so let's see how this one is going to go. Now, 639 is still the time to beat. As long as he finishes above... Oh, I forgot what the last time was. About 525, I believe. He's still in the shot to get third place, at least. So that is kind of like the minimum time he'll be aiming for. Interestingly enough, I do think Mozzarella is the only Diamond player. I could be wrong about this, but I think he was the only Diamond player to qualify. I'm pretty sure Freyko was the one Gold. Mozzarella was the one Diamond. And the rest was all Platinum players, which is quite interesting. I was kind of joking around with them that Platinum is the new Diamond, because they did kind of dominate this challenge. Now, my strategy here is going to be to go for a thick Cyclone all in. Nice try. Not gonna say that. I know he was half joking, but it was a good attempt, guys. It was a good attempt. I did forget what I was gonna say, but yeah, Platinum is the new Diamond. I'm gonna go for a mad Cyclone all in here. I think I want to proxy a factory. I'm just not quite sure. So I want to make one at home and one proxy, basically. I feel like for a holdout challenge like this, it makes sense to kind of have my production split. Because keep in mind, I'm going to have to kill a lot of hidden bases or hidden extractors or whatever. Like, ooh, okay. That is... Oh, man. He's not happy with the Terran, I see. That... Oh, okay. This looks like mass spine crawlers to me. Yeah. Okay, I see what's going on here. I feel like I can already tell what he's going to do. I think there's no gas here, right? I think he's going to make mass spines. This does look like a prepared strategy, of course, as I expected. So I'm going to make... Oh, I could make a starport or a factory. I decided to go for the factory. What a starport would do is just lift my stuff past his spine crawlers, basically, right? But I would still have to kill them, which I think is going to be a little easier with tanks. So for that reason, I'm going to go for the second factory here. If he was going to go for like the same Nidus play he did before... In that case, I would have just gone for the mass Cyclone all in again. I think that would be, you know, the perfect strategy to deal with that. Now, let's see. He's probably building a couple spines already. Let's see. Oh, he was getting ready for it. He does have two queens, too. Yo, I do think his build looks insanely good. He's going to go for speed as well. Yeah, I do really like this build. This Reaper's not going to be able to do any damage against the queens. I do want to keep this Reaper alive no matter what. I think, you know what? This may be a little crazy, but I'm going to go scout the map already for drones. And the reason I'm doing that is because I don't think the Reaper is really going to add a lot of value over here. So I'm just going to be scouting the entire map for drones already. If I can find some, that would be fantastic.
I think last game he also, or the last game we played, is really funny. I feel like it was just yesterday. It's already like 3 weeks ago or something, I believe, or 2 weeks ago. But I think he also wanted to go for Burrow, or maybe I recommended that he went for Burrow. It was something like that. Oh, I'm going to fly my barracks across. I could make another barracks here too for vision. Like, I do need vision. This barracks is going to arrive a little late, but it's not the biggest deal ever. You know what, guys? Actually, that's a really cool strategy. I'm going to make the bear. Oh, I'm going to kill this overlord. Because of the barracks. There we go. I think it's a pretty cool strategy. If I get two barracks here, because one thing that could kill my stuff relatively easily is mass speedlings. And he is going to have two hatcheries building those with an extractor, right? So if I get like two barracks to help me wall off, I feel like that would be absolutely awesome. Now, let's see. This Reaper could maybe give me some high ground vision, but I do have to be very careful here. I did scout most of the map, so I would imagine that I saw most things already. Let's see. Where's the spines? There's the spines. He has a couple spines. I still want to not lose that Reaper. I think I could actually go for a scan here. Keep in mind, I don't necessarily need to keep a good economy or something like that. Okay, so that first spine is probably going to die. I think it might barely survive because of that transfuse. Yeah, it is going to survive. And now I got my two barracks here already. We are currently at 420 in the game, which means I do have to kill him pretty fast from this point on. There we go. The barracks has arrived. I do think with the amount of spines and stuff he built, he is not going to have that many Zerglings, which is going to be really good for me. Okay, I'm going to get a couple of lock-ons there. And now, just make sure I don't die to the freaking Brutelings, because that would be a little annoying if I did. See, I'm going to see he's a little closer now. I feel like it would be really good for me to fight this, because like Queens can kill the Cyclones, but I... Okay, he does have a lot of Zerglings coming out now. I'm really afraid of the Zergling speed, to be fair. Okay, oh, so I did lose the Reaper now, but we are doing a lot of damage. He's going to come in with a couple Zerglings. Please... Oh my good, my own Cyclone almost died to the tech shield. Good thing I have an SUV that can repair those. And let's see, does he have the Nidus? I would imagine that he has the Nidus again. I'm not quite sure what else he would use the lair for. Exactly, so the Nidus is up already. I'm already going to start scouting around the map a little bit. Yeah, so the drones are already evacuated. I kind of would have preferred it if we would have stuck around a little longer, to be fair, because this position was very defendable for like a little more with the queens. But let's just go around the map now. I do have these cyclones, of course, that are going to help me. There we go. Found a drone, which means the Nidus is probably on the left side, which I already thought it was because I believe I heard the Nidus sound come from here. Now he's gonna lose a lot of these. Let's see. Oh, he's gonna try to surround my Cyclone. That's pretty funny, not gonna lie. Okay, I'm not gonna use my Cyclones to tank that. I think instead I would just use these to kill the Nidus like this. That should be a good idea. Looks like he was trying to build something there, but then he ran it to my freaking factory. Let's see. Okay, so we see all the buildings over there. I think I could still kill him in time here, even before... Oh, he does have all those Zerglings, right? Yeah, those Zerglings are going to keep him alive for quite a while. Let me make sure I don't waste stuff on the freaking larva. That'd be annoying. Oh, he's trying to surround the Cyclones, but at the same time, he is going to reveal the drones with that. He's not going to get the Cyclone if I microed correctly. There we go. And let's see, I'm just going to go on to the top over here. I wonder if I can maybe split my fire better by going like this, because my reinforcements are going to be able to kill that. I love seeing that knight is just chilling there, by the way. Like, it looks very funny. I do actually have to kill the queens first because the queens have the transfuses. Hey, there we go. Gonna be able to kill these final drones as well. My units are coming in from the bottom side. And it looks like it's gonna be a pretty close time to spot it, but he is gonna take over the rank one spot. It's actually incredibly close. Let's see, does he have another building somewhere else? I don't think so. And we are gonna kill him at 6:45, roughly. Which means he would beat the rank one time by about 6 seconds. That is incredibly close. And that means two things. That means Mozzarella is now guaranteed top three into the prize money, at least $200. And it also means that dude is now out of the top three officially. But this was very, very close to spot. And spot is not going to be happy seeing that he was beaten by just 6 seconds. But I did say Mozzarella was a contender. He did a good job. I think my build was pretty good as well. Maybe I could have gone for the proxy first factory. But then again, the Cyclones wouldn't have done anything earlier. Like, I really needed the tanks. It's good that I got the read on the spine crawlers. If I just went for mass Cyclones, this would have been a very tough one. Still got a pretty good time. I think last time he got 7:30. Now it's 6:45. So he beat it by 45 seconds. But we're not done yet. We have two contestants to go. Let's go for game number five.
The fifth opponent is going to be Nomad, a Platinum Protoss player who was the winner of the Terran holdout episode. And we are going to get Terran again. Okay, so this is the second rematch, I believe, right? Yeah, this is the second rematch of the episode. I think the first one we got, I don't remember what it was. I think we got a ZVT. No, we got a ZVP where we played ZVP last time as well. Now, I think I'm going to go for a similar strategy with the Proxy Reaper, and then I'm just going to see
what I'm going to do as follow-up based on what I scout. I feel like what I did last time with the tanks was just really good against someone going for cannons, right? So I could totally do something like that again if our opponent is going to go for cannons. Now, let's see. The time he has to beat to be first place is 6:45, I believe. And the time he has to beat to have a chance for third place is 6:14 by Freiko. And then if he wants to be confirmed top three but not first place, I don't know why you would want to beat that instead of just first, but if he wanted to, he would have to beat 6:39 by Spotted. So that's how long he's going to be trying to survive. I'm going to go for the Proxy Reaper again. It's a little close. On the last map, I liked it more. On this map, it feels, I don't know, for some reason, it's just like next to this giant wall where there could be buildings. Oh man. Oh, that is actually a sick trick. How did he know? Oh my god, I knew I was gonna read it. You prepare with my favorite thing, we'll deliver it soon. By the way, this is exactly how long text can be tested. Good luck and fun. Okay. I did read it. It was distracting. It did give me a little bit of a mental explosion, but I think my build is still on point, so that's good. Now I could see his probe move out. We know that he has 2 probes out on the map at least. He actually came back to try and kill it. Yeah, that's what I've expected. Now this SCV is going to check if he's going to go for cannons. This is pretty much what I did in the previous TVP. See, there's a lot of probes out there, actually. Yeah, it is a forge again. All right, that's pretty much what I expected. So, you know what? I'm just going to build it right here. I think I'm going to build my tanks right in front of his face. Because why the hell not? I mean, my Reaper is going to finish at a pretty decent time. That SCV is doing absolutely nothing right now. So that's a little bit annoying. My economy being slightly worse than it should be. Now, I could kill... Yeah, I think I'm going to kill this probe. I'm going to bait his probe to my barracks. I don't want to waste time killing the probe because I want to jump into the main ASAP. But if I can kill that probe first, that's going to be pretty nice. Okay, he's going to make a pylon now. The pylon to the mineral line is going to be a little bit later than it could have been. So that is going to be a little problematic for him as well. His economy is definitely going to take a nosedive after this right away. Like, this Reaper is not going to be defended until he makes a cannon, because I don't think he has a cybernetic score. Oh, this Reaper is going to do so much damage, guys. I can even make more Reapers now. Okay, there we go. He's going to make a cannon, but I'm pretty sure I can actually kill the cannon with my 2 Reapers. I don't think I've ever had this situation. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I can just kill that now. And I'm going to use my barracks for vision again. Yeah, he made that cannon too late, so the cannon is going to die, and his economy is going to keep getting worse and worse. As you can see, he's now having to pull SCVs or pull probes to deal with my Reapers, rather. I do think he has a cannon out here. Let's see. He didn't even... No, the Adept is on the outside. Oh, no. That is a disaster for Nomad here, guys. The Adept finished on the outside. He did actually have a cyber score. He prepared properly. He didn't necessarily need the cannon, but the Adept. Please recall that Adept, my friend. You have all the energy. You need that Adept to be in your main base now, defending these Reapers. He's not going to have a single probe left, not even to run away. Let's see. Yeah, he's I don't think he's really thinking about the recall, or maybe he was just trying to defend the front or something like that, but this is very, very painful for him. Now, I'm going to start using my SCVs. I'm going to use multiple SCVs to just scout around my base. I got 1 tank. I'm not actually sure I want to fight against a Zealot, because a Zealot is freaking terrifying for a tank, by the way. Like, Zealots are just freaking strong, you know? Like, the Adept is not going to do any damage to this tank, but the Zealot's going to be popping off. Let's see if this was the right decision. Yeah, I think it's barely going to be okay with the kiting, because the Adept should be losing this still. Okay, there we go. So now that's going to die. He doesn't have any mining. I'm going to try my best to find his buildings out on the map. He's not making another unit. He's killing his own wall because he was trying to get into his own base. Let's see. I'm going to fly the barracks a little closer. I think he's a cannon. Exactly. Now, I do have to say, guys, I saw the other guys talking about Nomad in the pre-chat, and apparently he was the most nervous of them all. So I think we can see a little bit of a product of that. I'm going to drop this mule to repair that. He still hasn't, you know, regained mining. To be fair, I didn't find a building out on the map yet. So that is really well done by him. Like, he must have hidden it really, really well. I'm going to unseat those guys. He doesn't even have money to make cannons at this point, which is freaking brutal. He could try to sneak out a probe still, so I'm going to have to probably just keep my tanks around here. Like, I don't need to bile or kill a specific target or something. Like, I can just stay around here and keep killing everything. I really feel like I want more SCVs on the map because I have enough money and I want to find the building, but I just have no idea where the freaking building would be. Like, I feel like I've checked everywhere already. I'm going to send even more SCVs out on the map. Maybe it's just in the middle somewhere. Let's see. I feel like I have been evolving in, like, many different ways, right? Like, even sending SCVs out on the map in this final episode. I definitely, you know, came to bring it to them here. Definitely not going to make it easy for them to win my dollar reduce here. Now, it's 1 gas. I haven't found another building on the map. Have you killed the probe? And we did indeed kill the probe. He actually... Wait, what happened to the scouting probe? Because so he had two probes out on the map, right? He had the one probe that came back to scout my proxy barracks. I killed that one. But he also had a probe that he used to drop this cheese. Did he maybe accidentally send it back to my back to his base? Or did I kill it on accident without paying attention and I forgot? I don't think it was the same, you know, probe that scouted the barracks. But as it stands, I think this is the last time currently. I think it's about 9 seconds below dude or 5 seconds. I know dude at like 520 or 525 or something. So even though he won the Terran challenge, he's not going to be able to make it happen today. And that confirms that Spotted is now also officially on the top three. So for now, Mozzarella is in first place, confirmed top two. Spotted is in second place, confirmed top three. And Freyko is in third place. Freyko definitely going to be hoping that the last player does not catch up to him so he can get his $200. But we'll have to find out. Let's go for the final game of the Holdout Challenge. And the final game is going to be against Stojvanovic. Random against random. The same portrait against the same portrait. I think it's called 15-year Protoss or 10-year Protoss or whatever it's called, 5-year Protoss, I don't know. But anyway, Stojvanovic was the second place player from the Zerg Holdout Challenge. I'm pretty sure he got Terran from random, and he was the guy that was good with the planetaries. I think that's what I remember. Now, this is also going to be a little weird for me, because I don't know how to cheese this guy, because he's random. I still have the same opinion that I had at the start, that random is probably a bit of an advantage. Now, I mentioned it a bunch of times. Ooh, you please go across not to the map. But for him to win, he's going to have to get above 645. That's going to be his time to win. That's how long he needs to survive. I think previously, but he might have even, I think he got like beyond 8 minutes or something like that. So, you know, he's definitely capable of doing that. But he needs to get above 645 to win the challenge. He needs to get above 639 to get second place. And he needs to get at least 614 or 615 if he wants to get top three. If he gets below 614, then he's out. Okay, there we go. So he's Terran again, and he's going to go for an instant planetary. That's a really fast planetary. Okay, wait. I need to think about this. How do I want to deal with this? So the last time, I'm pretty sure he made two planetaries next to each other. And he also hit one out on the map. So ideally, I send SCVs out to scout the proxies already. How do I want to do this? I think sending the Reaper is not going to be as good. Okay, so there's an SCV moving out already. Let's see, we found that one. That is nice. I'm not going to chase it forever because I really want to make a factory just like right in his face, like right over here. I'm going to use these Marines. I'm not going to make Reapers. I'm just going to make Marines. And I'm going to use them just to hold positions out on the map, pretty much. Like, I'm just going to try to find this command center no matter what. I'll use this SCV to patrol the bottom side, and then this Marine to patrol the top side. I think that is a decent plan. Do need to make another depot as well. This build is a little messed up, but that is all right. Like, as you can tell, I have no money whatsoever right now, but I think it's all right. Okay, so I'm just going to patrol this, and there we go. And then I'll send this Marine to patrol the top bases over there. Like, even an SCV should be good enough if I find the command center. Where the hell are you going? If I find the command center in time, right? Because if I find the command center in time, I will be able to just kill the SCV building it. That's a big downside of Terran, of course. I think I'm going to go for the starport here, by the way. Because starport is going to help me kill the SCVs repairing the planetary. I think that is a smart move. Let's see. So we haven't found anything yet, unfortunately. I guess I'll just make a depot in the main. I've always... I mean, I don't think so, but I've always seen them talk about building something in my main base. So I guess I might as well build a depot there. Imagine if he flies something into the main base. That would be cool. Now, I still haven't found the command center, so I'm just going to keep running these around forever until I do actually get there. Let me make sure to hotkey this properly. Oh, no. Okay, this is a little unfortunate. I think one of my hotkeys is... I talked about this before. One of the hotkeys on my keyboard is dying a little bit, so that's going to make this a little more of a challenge. So there's another SCP moving out there. I'm just going to follow that one forever, I think. Like, I don't think I really need to keep my things at home anymore. Okay, so there is one SCP. If I can hit it with my SCP, then it's never going to escape my grasp anymore, which would be super, super nice. I'm just going to be trying to kill him with these tanks, basically. Let's see, where's the SCP? Okay, there we go. We did find that SCP, which is super nice for us. And I suppose we're just going to be attacking the front. I'm going to make a Liberator as well. Did we kill... Oh, I think we killed the SCV. He's going to start building something over there. Why is my SCV not doing anything? You can go over here as well. I think I'm going to be able to kill it. Oh, barely not. Go all the way around. I do want to kill that. Let's see. I'm going to start killing his wall now, which is nice. I think I'm going to keep making Vikings. So that one falls. Let's see. I'm actually going to scout a little bit with this Viking to see what he has. So there has to be... Yeah, there's a planetary over there. I don't see another one yet, though. Okay, he's going to try to make one there. That makes a lot of sense. It doesn't seem like he really has anything besides the command center. So I'm just going to go for it over here. Then make sure to kill this. That one is going to die to the Marine eventually. I don't think he has... another SCV out on the map, but just to be sure, I'm gonna check again with this Marine. I feel like it would just be smart for me to check. I can also use a couple more SCVs again, just in case. Like, I already have enough money to do what I want to do. I do know the last time we played, he tried to make a tank with this as well. Now, I'm going to have a really good Liberator here. That's going to kill all these SCVs. Yeah, he has a turret, but he's not going to be able to kill that Liberator. Liberators have a fantastic amount of range, so he's going to be trying to repair. I can probably target the SCVs as well with a tank. Those are all going to fall. Look at that. Those SCVs have no chance of escaping, pretty much. Now, I'm still... Look at the minimap. I'm checking absolutely everywhere. This base is gonna fall really freaking fast, guys. Now, what am I gonna do with the Liberator? I think I'll keep the Liberator over there. I see that he has an SCV over here. I'm just gonna try to defend the front with these units that I have left. Like, I would imagine that he's gonna try to escape at some point. I found an SCV, right? Oh, it's an engineering bay. Yeah, okay, we did find it. It is very well hidden, I have to say. Like, incredibly well hidden, but we are gonna find it. I don't know if he has SCVs left. Yeah, he has a couple SCVs left here. I think I'm gonna be able to kill all of those relatively comfortably. He also has a building in the bottom left. Like, he did a great job hiding these, I have to admit. I really was looking for command centers, and I think he realized that, so he's gonna be trying to hide buildings everywhere. Do I have enough to kill these in time? I'm not sure. Maybe I'm gonna go for this one first. These tanks are gonna be able to take care of this. 614 is the time he's trying to beat, guys, and it's gonna be very, very closer, I think. 614. I haven't even thought about the fact what happens if there's, like, a freaking tie. I do think we should be able to eliminate him a little faster unless he has another building hitting. It's gonna be a pretty sick race. I love that he made a Marine there as well, by the way, just to try and survive a little bit longer. But the depot's gonna fall, the barracks gonna fall. This might be the last eBay over here. Let's see. I'm looking at the minimap. We have anything else, and he doesn't. And that is going to be it for the challenge. I think it was 5:59. Putting him in fourth place, and that means we have our top three guys. Mozzarella is our champion at 6:45. I could be wrong with these times by like 1 second or whatever, by the way. Like, I could just be misremembering. But Mozzarella is our champion at 6:45. Gonna take down $500, which is awesome. Congrats to Mozzarella. Spotted is going to be second place with 6:39. Gonna take home 300. And Freko, our gold league protoss, by the way, the lowest league player of this challenge, is gonna take home $200 for third place. That is awesome. Very, very well done. Congrats to him. And that's shows that, you know, I don't know how many diamond players competed, but it was a lot. But the gold player in the end qualified and made top three, and that is freaking awesome. Well done to them. And this was a fantastic community challenge. Hope you all enjoyed it. We're going to be doing more community challenge. Not sure if we'll do a holdout challenge again, because there's so many things to do. But if you have a suggestion for the next community challenge, please let me know, because I had a fantastic time giving back to my community, having a good time with you guys in the Discord as well. And obviously join the Discord if you want to participate in any of these or just chill with my community. But for today, that's going to be it. Congrats to the winners. I'm gonna chill because I'm tired trying to... I was really on point today, by the way, I have to admit. Like, I killed them all very, very fast. Can't be proud of that. But I'm gonna relax. Hope you guys had a fantastic time. If you did, like the video, subscribe to the channel, and to see y'all for the next one. Adios.